David Pegler here. This is your European Outlook for November the 11th, 2009. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Quick reminder, not alert service, not going to make any trade recommendations during the course of a day, but what I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis, hopefully help you put together some good positive trade plans. Please keep in mind trading heavily leveraged, always risky business, so please do not trade real money until you have a good proven track record of success using a demo. Okay, folks, I'm going to cover the pound and the Aussie briefly today, and then we'll call it a day. Quite a boring video I have in mind, honestly, more boring than usual, I should say, because it's everything's kind of right at that pinnacle of can I continue or am I going to make a significant retracement, and we are right there on a lot of currencies. So I'm going to look at Aussie, going to look at pound, and we'll move on. Okay, so this is your Aussie dollar daily chart. All right, everything's looking phenomenal here to the upside, right? We touched this trend line bottom, and you know we're continuing now to make a series of higher highs and higher lows. The only thing that's big, you know, yesterday we came down more or less, touched the five, plenty far enough retracement for us to continue. The only thing now is that we effectively going into this Asian slash European session here, and we are right at that 93.20 resistance, all right, just off it, but effectively right at it. So now it's a question of this, it's a question of, well, are we going to see a fib of the rise today? Meaning that, are we going to come down and do something like this? In which case, you know, this chart is still long. All right. Alternatively, are we just going to break these highs, the Bollinger Bands wide open to the upside? Are we just going to break these highs and continue mission to the upside? All right. So that's the question I want to answer today. And the only, you know, once again, you guys see me do this a lot, but I'm really am going to employ a trap today to help us answer that question. Look at this on the 4 hour, how we never really made a big retracement. I think we went just far enough that we have permission to continue, but we didn't even make a 382 of this last rise. Alright, if you consider this the last major swing points, yes, there was an extremely shallow retracement. Alright, I wouldn't be surprised to see us push down to the bottom of this range here again, more around the 91.70 area if we were to be in a retracement mode today. So what I'm going to do is set two very decisive parameters for shorts and longs here. Okay, so if we go to the hourly, you know, scratch it, let's go to the 15 minute. All right, you'll notice that we obviously have this resistance area at the 93.20 zone. Okay, you can also look at doing something like this if you really, really want to test this to the upside. And then if you'll notice yesterday we formed up a little bit of resistance here, now to become support through this 92.90, you know, call it 92.88 level. All right, look at the swing highs here, swing highs here, swing highs here. You know, cluster it through here, cluster through here. And you know, it was important all the way through here again. So I want to make that my little downside break. You know, the very conservative is obviously to trap the bottom here and do nothing in between, but I think that there's enough pips that we can play in between here. All right, so you know, if we break 92.88 to the downside, I'm then thinking pull back short, okay, but not only just short to the bottom of this trap, this would be a much larger play looking for you know, the late 91, so potentially 100 pip drop. Said differently, if we can break out of this general 93.17, 93.100 area to the upside, I think we're probably going to rise 80 to 100 pips without too many problems. But right in between here, I frankly have no idea what she wants to do. It's, you know, it's bullish on more time frames than I can see, but I do also see the fact that we made a very shallow retracement. We might want to double dip this retracement down to support, and that's why I'm looking at the trap. If we break these highs, you know, it's all aboard the Aussie train again, and let's keep on going. You know, gold sitting $1,100, silver through the roof, all the other good stuff. So, you know, if she wants to head up, all aboard, right? No fighting it, but that little trap is, you know, just fine for us to trade, I think. All right, the other one, quick look at is cable. And the same thing, all right. We, you'll notice this all important resistance area at the 6750 zone, all right, and the support zone here at 6600. Well, yesterday there's actually a nice little short, and then the news kicked us in to move us down. But you'll notice now that we've come down, hit the 66 area, okay, nice little long opportunity. She's bounced off there and now come all the way back, and lo and behold, yep, you guessed it, we stopped at 6750. All right, so you know, on a 4 hour, this is nothing more than a retracement for continuation, no big deal. However, you know, on an hourly level, I'm sure a lot of folk are looking at this and thinking, yeah, okay, great, this is nothing more than a bounce pullback, and we're going to continue to the downside by virtue of the fact that we are effectively making, you know, larger term lower lows and lower highs. All right, so yep, I'm going to employ another price trap. I know this is boring, but it's just the nature of where we are. Seems like we in these situations a lot when making these videos, and it's really this simple. You know, trap the little bottom here, and then the 60, you know, call it 6710 to 6700 area is your downside point. 6750 is your upside breakpoint, and then yep, we're looking for this again to 66. Alternatively, break the highs, yeah, I think then we, you know, then it's going to be a large day to the upside. We got nothing to stop us from going up and hitting, you know, 6850 and 6900 again. All right, so there it is. There's your outlook for November the 11th, 2009. Quick trading note. I would also keep, those of you that are futures traders, I'm not going to show you the chart, but there is a very, very clear descending wedge formed up on the December contract of Nat Gas. I would absolutely keep an eye on that. That is 100% due for a break any day now. And two, FX Bootcamp is now obviously got an Asian session with our coach Rob Helene, and he's also doing an Asian outlook. So I'd definitely look out on the Bootcamp blog and keep an eye on that. Good trader and a heck of an analyst. So I'd look out for his videos for something looking into the Asian market every day. All right. My name is David Pegler. This has been your European Outlook November the 11th. Please leave me some feedback at YouTube or blog. Much appreciated. And I'll chat to you tomorrow.